I ordered this tire pressure meter from AliExpress, and today I'll be sharing a complete video covering the unboxing, operation guide, installation, and configuration. Make sure to subscribe to my channel for more great content. Before we dive into the unboxing, let's take a look at some of the features highlighted on the box. It includes solar charging, USB charging, pressure monitoring, temperature monitoring, a digital display, and an anti-high temperature monitoring system. When you open the box, you'll find a double-sided tape for securing the unit, and here is the user manual. Be sure to keep this manual safe, as it contains all the important installation and configuration instructions. Next, we have the tire pressure meter display, equipped with a solar panel. Along with it, you'll see four bolts and a wrench, and here's the charging cable. But most importantly, these are the tire pressure sensors. Let's check them out, one by one. This sensor is for the front left tire, this one is for the front right, this is for the rear left, and finally, the sensor for the rear right tire. You can charge the unit with this cable, but it also features a built-in solar panel for hassle-free charging. To power on the device, simply press this power button. Once it's on, you'll notice the tire pressure values show as zeros. This happens because the sensors aren't synchronized yet. However, before you begin the synchronization process, there are some configurations you need to complete first. Before installing the unit, as usual, I'm going to open the sensor. You can use the provided wrench to do this. Once opened, you'll see that the sensor is powered by a cell battery. When the battery runs out, you'll need to replace it. To configure the unit, press and hold the REM button. You'll see the maximum tire pressure value at the top and the minimum tire pressure value at the bottom. Press the button twice, and the maximum pressure value will start blinking. Now, use the arrow keys to adjust it. Once you've set it, press the REM button again. You can now adjust the minimum tire pressure level. After setting that, press the REM button to save. Next, the maximum temperature value will blink in the top right corner. Use the arrow keys to adjust it as well. Press Env again to save the data. When you exit the edit mode, you can switch the display units from PSI to bar using the arrow keys. Now that all the configurations are done, it's time to install the tire pressure sensors. First, power on the unit by pressing the power button. You'll see the display start blinking. Next, press the button shown in the video 8 times. Now, you can begin pairing the tire pressure sensors. You'll notice the front left tire value is blinking. Once it blinks, install the front left tire pressure sensor. Since this is an internal sensor, you'll need to install it by first removing the dust cap. Start by placing the provided bolt on the valve stem. We'll use this to secure the sensor later. Next, insert the sensor and tighten it fully. Once done, secure the sensor in place with the bolt. Be sure you're installing the correct sensor. As you can see, when we install the sensor, the tire pressure meter detects it automatically. Now that the front left sensor is paired, we can move to the next one by pressing the next button. You can pair all four sensors by following the same procedure. Simply press the next button to move to the next sensor, and the tire pressure sensor will be detected once it's installed on the tire. After all four sensors are connected and paired, press the REM button to save the data. Now that all the sensors are connected, you can see the tire pressure levels. Notice the front left tire pressure is at 23 psi, so I'm going to inflate that tire. I'm using my portable machine to add air. Once the pressure matches the value shown on this machine, I'll stop and reattach the sensor. As you can see, the tire pressure level adjusts accordingly. And that's it! All the sensors are now installed, configured, and working seamlessly. With this system, you'll have real-time insights into your tire pressure, ensuring better safety, fuel efficiency, and overall vehicle performance. It's a simple yet effective way to stay on top of your car's health without any guesswork. I hope you found this step-by-step guide helpful and that it makes your setup process smoother. Keeping an eye on tire pressure can significantly improve your driving experience, and with these sensors, you can do it effortlessly. If you enjoyed this video or learned something new, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Your support really helps the channel grow. And if you're new here, consider hitting the subscribe button and turning on notifications so you don't miss out on more useful tips, product reviews, and how-to guides. We've got a lot of exciting content coming up, and I'd love for you to be part of this journey. Feel free to drop any questions, suggestions, or feedback in the comments section below. I'm always happy to engage with you and help out in any way I can. Thank you for tuning in, and remember, be innovative, stay with SetNFix. I'll see you in the next video.